So we got the Iron Sheik. You want to hear the Iron Sheik?
Iron Sheik?
Iron Sheik is back.
What is he? He's back?
Yeah, he's one of our favorites.
What's he back for?
He did a promo for the WWE.
Oh.
WWE Online, I believe.
Yeah, they don't want to put him out front.
Yeah. Brand new audio from the Iron Sheik. We love the Iron Sheik in this on this radio show. You ready, Bobby, for Iron Sheik audio?
I love the Iron Sheik.
You love Iron Sheik?
I want to say to you, yes, Opie, I am champion of Iron Sheik radio. Go ahead.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, no. Ready? No.
All set?
No.
Great. I've been sitting here 6 days waiting to do this. My butt is asleep. Great.
Oh, no.
I just saw Sandy, little sweetheart, who everybody loves, including myself. And I, you're probably wondering who I am, Robert Kelly. I'm going to be with you for just a little bit. So please stick around because you are watching the Burly Bear Network. And check us out. Yes. Is that good? Is that all right?
No.
Wait a second. Opie?
I thought that. I didn't realize that was your voice.
That sounds very familiar.
What was that? Why are you sweating?
Oh, wait. I thought that was the Iron Sheik. Oh, my bad.
My bad.
I'd like to hear more Bob.
Yeah, that's the network. Of course.
That's Bob rules.
Bobby's part of the Burly Bear Network, huh?
Burly Bear Network? Yeah. Yes. I love it. It's my favorite channel.
Can I just explain what it is that you're hearing?
Please.
When I first moved to New York, I auditioned. This is my second audition ever, and I booked it. And I was a VJ, like MTV.
Like. But on the Burly Bear Network.
Which is
the hell is that? I never heard of it.
It's
Tim, tie your shoelaces, God's sake. You're going to trip.
It's a college network. It's only in colleges.
Oh.
It's a college television network that only gets piped into colleges. And
bathhouses.
And I was one of the first VJs.
The Burly Bear Network?
Do we have video of Bob like this? I want to see what he looks like.
Oh, you don't probably understand. Gorgeous.
Oh, you don't even know how good looking I am. You should see the hair.
How do we not have the video? Where is it?
Yeah, we'll get the video.
It's gorgeous.
Well, Bob explains how he's the new kid on the block for the Burly Bear Network. Were you like a twink?
Oh, I was
a twink. Yeah.
I guess you could call me a twink.
Or a sloppy party bottom.
Now I'm a twinkie, but yes.
Oh, Bob, don't go knocking yourself.
Hey, action. I got to say action, not the director. Because I'm Robert Kelly. I'm the new guy on the block. I'm the last guy of the day. That's right. I'm going to be your host for just a little bit. You are watching the Burly Bear Network, so please stick around and check us out.
Now you are the block.
How was that?
Oh. Why do you keep saying, how was that?
How was that? Was that good?
Yes, Dan.
Because even then, at that level, he understood that he sucked and was charmless. I hate his attempted charm. This is Robert Kelly. I'm the last guy of the day. You're kind of stuck with me, ladies and gents.
But we'll all get through it together.
Did you hear the gist a bit?
Yeah. Just a bit.
I stole that from MTV. Just a bit.
People, give it back.
People want to know if this was part of the Logo Network.
His phony confidence. Be back in just a bit. How was that? Okay?
Say it was good, please.
Say it was good.
Was this community college or real college?
I haven't heard of this, Bobby.
It's a Lorne Michaels, actually.
You know it's good then.
Yeah.
He actually
put out great stuff.
He put it out, and it was, I don't even know if it's still around, but it was like an MTV in colleges, and we,
Yeah, we get the college MTV part.
I just keep repeating myself because I'm in shock right now.
You're really trying.
Well, I know how much stuff you guys actually have on me today, and I'm just...
cringing.
Yeah, it's like the first wave to the tsunami is just hit me, but now I'm waiting for the second, and all the debris to start smashing into my knees.
Well, you get to intro a video here.
Oh! Let's hear Bob.
Hey, how's it going? I'm Robert Kelly, and I'm going to be hanging with you for just a few here at the Burly Bear. Coming up next, we have...
And I'm you're forced casual. I'd like to throw acid in your face. I'm going to be hanging with you just for a few.
For just a few?
You schmaltzy jerk off.
I love when Opie's enjoying something. He just stares at you with that smile. He gets his Opie dimples come out.
Don't try to deflect.
I'm trying.
Don't try to deflect.
What are you telling me? Not to
love
defend?
This.
You guys had your fun
just
with...
Just tell me not to defend myself.
You guys had your fun with the baby diaper mustache. Now it's your turn.
Yeah, don't get me. We're just hanging.
Yeah, why are you sweating? Look at your forehead.
Is Voss wearing one today?
Wearing what?
Oh. I'll be back in just a bit.
Just a bit.
Hold on.
When you talk and you say, this is Robert Kelly.
Hey, I know.
Because they all knew who you were back at the college campuses. This is Robert Kelly. Who?
Chew your teeth before you speak.
Well, just come over on the loudspeaker.
Last guy of the day.
This came over on a TV. It was a TV channel in colleges.
Was it?
And I would sit on a couch much like I'm doing now in a hip little room with all logos around. And
dude, not one person's calling that heard of this.
I've heard of the Burly Network only because I performed in a few colleges, but that was only because I was there. But he's going to be hanging there for just a bit.
Hey, how's it going? I'm Robert Kelly, and I'm going to be hanging with you for just a few here at the Burly Bear Network. Coming up next, we have a video clip from Will and Colin. Yes, with their latest Lose and Must. Very freaky video. You're going to want to check that out here at the Burly Bear. Stick around.
Oh. You know why you got the gig? Because nobody else auditioned and wanted to do it. It was you against yourself.
You know what, Bob?
We got what you said, dummy. Will you spice it up, Voskum?
You know that you really this is right. You should be saying back in a jiff.
Well, you know, I booked the gig. It was improv. You just mess around.
I would hope that was improv.
Wow.
It couldn't have been written.
And they just kind of stick you in a room with a camera guy and a sound guy.
They say your name incessantly, and then just tell people what you're doing and how long you're going to be there for. I'm Robert Kelly. I'll be hanging with you just for a bit. You know.
Hey, Robert Kelly here, and I know that makes you happy. We're here at the Burly Bear Network. Coming up, we have some clips from the kids in the hall. Do you know how they got their name? I know how. And if you know how, please email me at burlybear.com and let me know that you know. Stick around. This is Robert Kelly. You're watching the Burly Bear. Don't go away.
Anthony's hair on his arm is sticking up.
I just pointed to my arm, to Bob. I just pointed at my arm because I swear to you, I just got like goosebumps.
Kids in the hall, how'd they get their name? I have a guess. Your loveless childhood.
Did you run down the hall to a computer, seeing how many people were responding?
Yeah, come on. Oh, I bet the emails. Yeah. You refresh, nothing.
Kids in the
spam.
Hall, kids in the hall in college, so they don't have to watch this crap on TV.
Rich tapped out.
You could just email me at the Burly Bear Network.
That's it. You just need to. Go into the bathroom, take a breath,
Rich is
splash
really,
some water on your face.
Rich is really saving me. Sorry, I stepped in that great line.
They're very funny.
That's it for Burly Bear today. I've been Robert Kelly. This
for you now.
You didn't do anything.
Exactly.
You did nothing.
No, but you have to.
You haven't even done anything.
You have to imagine videos popping up right at the end of my speeches.
I've been Robert Kelly, and you've been bored.
Well, needless to say, they didn't have me back Robert for a second season.
Oh.
Yeah.
How did they tell you?
By not calling.
Oh.
Yeah.
I hate your charming voice. You know, just a guy relaxing, watching.
Yeah, you really are just trying to be like, hey. Yeah.
That's it for Burly Bear today. I've been Robert Kelly. This is my zit, Frankie. Say hi to Frankie.
Hi, guys.
Yes, and have a happy Thanksgiving. Me and Frankie going back to Massachusetts to enjoy some turkey. You do the same. Thanks for watching the Burly Bear Network. We'll catch you next time.
Is that Bobby's phone?
Who's calling you? The people from the shuttle? What if that's Lauren?
I hate this iPhone. I'm definitely getting... If the iPhone does this...
It makes so much damn noise.
It's not. It's interference with other electronic stuff, which means
that's
going through my brain.
Easily, with no resistance.
Wow. Should be the quick little gunslinger, isn't it?
You're rolling. All right, good, because I'm Robert Kelly. You're watching Burly Bear. I just got back from vacation. You see this hat? This is very lovely. You see this right here? I love this. Because it's Christmas time coming up, my favorite holiday. Thanksgiving's over. That's the little get warm holiday. You know, you eat a little turkey, get fat, fall asleep, eat some more, and then throw up. That's what I do. We're going to be, I'm going to be with you for the rest of the Burly
doing.
Bear.
Why aren't you throwing up these days?
Oh, wow. Oh, man.
Everybody had one cocked and loaded.
Firing squad right there.
We should have just went around the room. We all went at the same time.
Yikes.
Yeah, did you really need Voss in today? It's like eight That's people it. Are going to... No, I didn't mean that. I meant that as a compliment, like you're going to smash me, too. I didn't mean
smash you.
As soon as I said that, I knew your self-esteem was on the line, so I had a. Yeah. I meant it as a compliment.
I just wanted... You never answered how the kids in the hall got their name.
That's true. How did they get the name?
Yeah,
how did,
actually,
I'm dying to know.
I'll tell you. They used to do a show, and the guys would do a show, and they'd have a bunch of kids... And then people would boo. People would boo because there wasn't enough jokes. And people would boo again. And they would like, what the hell? We need jokes. And they had a bunch of kids in the hall. And they'd run out and go, get me a joke from the kids in the hall. And the people, they'd just
la, 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 la.
And they'd be out there in the hall going, la, 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 la.
Pitted. So pitted.
And then he was pitted. I don't know what that meant.
Right. Shut up.
Why do you say your name so many times? Who's this show for? Goldfish? Like every 8 seconds, they forget everything they've ever learned.
No, he's thinking people are going, oh, it's Bob Kelly.
I'm Robert Kelly.
Robert Kelly. And that's he's back on again, thank God.
I bet you were all lounged out trying to be charming.
Oh, God.
Dad, you know what, dude? It was a long time ago. I was new. You know what, dude? I learned.
Thank God, though, he didn't in that last segment because I couldn't see it, but I know this didn't happen. What? You didn't have a Santa hat on.
Oh, God, I gotta go.
Did he have a Santa hat?
Of course he did.
He must have.
I didn't see it. I know he had a Santa hat on.
I don't have the video here. Where's the video?
It's obvious.
Where's the video?
It's around, Jimmy. We're playing the audio version.
But I want to see it.
Yeah, we'll get the video up for everybody. Oh. We'll get some clips up on onaradio.com. You can visualize. There's Bobby with his Santa hat.
Talking about Christmas with a hat.
Right.
You don't understand how.
You probably spelled douche wrong, which is what you should have. D-W-C-H-E.
Hat should have been removed, like Arba Dwyer's hair.
Oh.
Jesus.
Oh.
That's true. Where's Oswald? I'd like him to take your hat off. Could Sirhan assist in Santa hat removal, please? Hey, Mr. Hinckley, can I borrow that hat removing apparatus you're holding?
Holiday. Thanksgiving's over. That's the little get warm holiday. You know, you eat a little turkey, get fat, fall asleep, eat some more, and then throw up. That's what I do.
What's this last year?
I'm going to be with you for the rest of the Burly Bear, so please stick around. Sit your butt down, shut your pie hole, put the pencils away, and watch me, because I will get Italian on you if you don't, okay?
Uh-oh.
You're watching Burly Bear. Stick around, because I love you. Oh.
Oh, so many mixed messages there.
The last part of that,
they had to put their pencils down?
Yes. Well,
it's college, you know.
Why, were they stabbing themselves in the eyes?
They want to hang.
Can I just say something? When we were doing this to you guys, it was so much fun, and I never thought of the other side of it.
Oh, it's the worst place to be.
I don't understand why I would do this.
Hold on now. Let me be a little cuter and more charming. Just sit your little butt down in the chair. Put away your pencils. You're in good hands. I'd like to sink my teeth into your face.
Who wants to get Italian on you right now?
Oh, what does
Ooh,
that
yeah.
mean? What does that mean?
You're going to do it. You're going to mix cement?
Or sauce.
I'm going to cheat on my wife.
Ooh. Well, this next clip is labeled, "We Never Know What Bobby's Going to Do."
Whoa. Wow.
Unpredictable
wow.
Bobby.
He's wild.
That was a shock jock.
Shock jock. You're a shock jock.
Robert Kelly here with the nose here.
Right.
Yes, I'm going to be with you for the rest of your day. So stick around, because you know you like watching me, because you never know what I'm going to do. I could just grab this guy over here, who's the writer, and pull him in, and then throw him away. Because he's just trying, you know, he's not doing anything, getting paid millions.
You're certainly not.
$35.50 an hour, but that's okay. And next up, we got kids in the hall, very funny guys, so please stick around, have some laughs with them. You're watching Burly Bear. I'm going to breathe, because that's what I do when I talk. I don't breathe, because I'm Italian.
What? How bad do those students wish they were going to Kent State?
Absolutely.
Where's Charles Whitman when you need him?
But I don't know why he picks Kent State. We had 9 shootings at colleges this year, and he has to go back to when he was
when he was in college.
Exactly.
I never went to
God
college.
Damn it, Jimmy.
What's wrong with you?
Thank you for helping me. Kent State. What are you, an ass? You had a shooting... In that last week, you moron.
It doesn't matter. It's more hip to use something retro like that.
Is it?
Really?
I could remember it.
Oh, we're talking about antique furniture. We're talking about jokes, you loser.
I know. I'm sorry. We're just hanging. Yeah. Don't get Italian on me.
You never know what Bob Roberts going to do. I love the fact that you said that he's the writer. He ain't doing nothing.
Yeah.
Truer words have never been spoken.
Obviously.
You know.
Was he a mongoloid?
They can only see you now every day, Thanksgiving.
Put your pencils down, and all the writers are like, ours have perfect points. Nothing has been written.
Well, they used to just, this is, they literally, you were in an office, the offices of the network, and they, there was no studio, it was just the offices.
Oh, so that was
kind
of cool.
So you just, they would literally just say, go. You want to say Burly Bear, that's it. Don't say Burly Bear TV, and just say your name, what's coming up, and blah. And then I would just go, that's it? And they'd be like, yeah. And I would just have to wing it with my charm.
Did the guy move the camera a lot in and tilt it?
Yes,
exactly. A lot of that kind of.
They were on the floor with the angle looking
at
me.
Yeah, getting some weird angle like they did in the 90s all the time.
We want to squeeze these next two clips in before break. This next one is, wow, this is a good one. This is a good one, Bobby. He's threatening to do things if you don't watch.
Step back.
That's right. Put on your cute hats, ladies and gentlemen.
Look out. Here he comes.
Robert Kelly here. Little dance for you. Robert Kelly, Burly Bear Network is what you're watching. Next up, we have The Flip Side with Godfrey, your host. He's down at NYU talking to some students about what they want to talk about because it's their show, it's your show, it's everyone's show because we're the Burly Bear. That's what we do for you. So don't you go anywhere. I will jump off this balcony. Do you want that? I don't think you do. And I don't want to jump.
And bounce right back up.
Oh, okay.
Actually, back then I was very in shape, Mr. Voss. I would have to.
Not verbally.
Why? Well, there you go. Were you acting it out?
He gets a good one and then just follows it up.
I will jump off this balcony, and you don't want me to do that, especially if you're living in Indonesia. Oh, that makes me sick to my stomach.
I was on a... They just threw me on a fire escape and told me that you should have...
Yeah, because it's crazy. Oh,
you're wild.
Like the omen, you should have just put a rope around your neck and threw yourself off the balcony.
Maybe they put you on a fire escape because they didn't want to hear you in the office anymore. Maybe not.
What's wrong with you today?
I will jump off this balcony.
Every other one's
do you
good.
Want that? I don't think you do. And I don't want to jump, but if you leave, that's what I'm doing. Ooh, look at the woman.
I've never seen Jimmy so depressed and angry.
I'm disgusted on a level. If you were convicted of pedophilia, it would still be easier to look at you
than it is right now. Yeah, for you.
Yeah, of course.
The last clip. Bobby has a great... And great is in all capitals here.
Oh, no.
Line about cookies.
Oh, I bet it's cute, whatever it is.
Why'd I give you this one?
Sorry. Robert Kelly here. Next up on Burly Bear Network, we have a special Christmas fa-la-la-la-la-la-la edition of Half-Baked with Matt Fry, where he attempts to make Christmas cookies. It's more like Christmas jerky cookies because they're very salty, but you're going to want to check it out anyways, so stay tuned.
I was trying to...
Can we hear that one again at one point? I'm not ready to give up on that one yet. I think that deserves another listen.
Another round.
Fa-la-la-la. You must have improv that cookie line. Was that the crack writing stand?
I feel like I'm in a sauna.
That does nothing.
Here. Next up on Burly Bear Network, we have a special Christmas fa-la-la-la-la-la-la edition of Half-Baked with Matt Fry, where he attempts to make Christmas cookies. It's more like Christmas jerky cookies because they're very salty, but you're going to want to check it out anyways, so stay tuned.
You get it because jerky's salty and the cookies were kind of salty.
Wow.
No, I don't.
It's just improv. It's one letter short of improve, you know?
It's so...
Man, you can go either way. That's all I'm saying. Ask Drew Carey.
Hey, let's say hi to Augie from Massachusetts. Okay. Augie, what's up?
Hey, how you doing? I actually saw Bobby on the Burly Bear when I was in college.
Oh, did you?
It was actually pretty good. Hey, Bobby, why didn't they call you back for another season? It was pretty good.
Oh, thanks, man.
Not you!
Oh, Jesus. You think I need that right now, sir?
They actually just re-showed Bobby's Burly Bear year at NYU, and that's one of those jumping deaths.
At least you picked one in this century.
And the city, local.
Yeah, let's go to John in North Carolina. John, or Joe, what's up?
good morning, boys.
Hey, what's up, Joe?
Jimmy.
Hey, buddy.
I just wanted to verify that I worked at a college station here about 8 years ago. Now, we did run the Burly Bear Network, and I can't say I remember Bob Kelly, but I do remember the show he was just talking about in that last clip, Half Baked, which was actually pretty good. It wasn't a bad show at all.
Stop it.
Bob,
it was.
Bob was not so memorable.
You said you don't remember me.
I do remember them running videos and stuff, but I don't remember you per se.
So you can't say that I'm not rememberable if you don't remember me.
Right. All right. Thanks, and, sir.
Speaking of funny is funny.
Should I have kids come up? Guys?
Oh, wow. I blew that. I mean, that would have been all right, too. But speaking of funny.
It's just that sometimes it's easier to keep running away from things rather than to commit to the hard choices, even the ones that make us happy.
It was 11.
You mean like falling in love happy, getting married happy, having kids, that kind of happy? Gino, you think my parents were happy, Joe? Wrong. They were fucking miserable. For years I had to go through that. Years.
So is this about them or you?
Hey, man, no offense, but you know me for like 12 weeks. And granted, I admit my head's a little screwed up, but there's no way in hell you know me well enough to understand why.
I understand that you can't keep running away from the thing you're chasing. That's what's making you crazy, not pizza.
Puerto Rican. Stay out of my head, okay?
Oh, Bob Kelly.
And bliss my ass. I'm going on break.
Wow. look at me.
Is this a play?
Look at me. Great.
You're not Irish.
Look at me.
Oh, God.
How good looking am I? Watch
look at his hair's blowing.
Look at that.
What is this?
Holy Jesus. When did you eat him?
We're seeing a video, obviously, Bobby doing some of this acting with a full head of hair. At least 120 pounds lighter.
Who are you acting with?
That's just his arm.
Jesus Christ. 120 pounds.
What is this? What movie is this?
Looks like The Outsiders.
This is Last Night at Eddie's. He's got
long, curly hair.
I was the romantic lead.
I see that. You're looking off into the distance between your lines.
If you heard this dialogue, you'd fucking throw up. Right now?
What's the scene? What's the scene?
You and Grandpa Lewis. That sounded good.
Oh, yeah. What's the scene?
Well, this is where I'm talking to her about the desert.
Are you talking about like traveling the world and finding God?
Yes. Yeah, finding God.
I really wish we had that.
California sunset's not so bad.
I'd like to see that someday, but I just don't get out that much.
You should. It's a beautiful country, Allison.
Last time I went down to the Colorado Rockies.
Pause that for a second.
From there.
It's a beautiful country, Alice. And I've opened for Dane all over it.
Oh.
Wow.
Look at him with his Jerry curling.
This is me talking to the retard kid.
Oh, got your mirror. Jerry curl in your hair.
But look at this. Watch this, though. Look at my lip. Look at that fucking face. Fuck you.
You look like a fucking Puerto Rican girl. You're like Rosie Perez.
Angel crisis before us today.
What?
Today, this afternoon, the Senate will pass its budget that we believe addresses the
Bob
economic
Kelly?
Crisis in a way that rejects new taxes.
All right, I thought it was a Spitzer crap.
Not when Spitzer comes on, they're going to...
Yeah.
You'll know it. Oh, Bobby's
from there, I went down to Navajo Valley, southern Utah, a place called the Valley of the Gods. As you can see, are these rock formations.
Why'd you go to the Valley of the Gods, Buddha?
Bobby, what's wrong? You all right?
He's acting.
The back of my neck hurts.
See, are these
holding
rock
up that head.
I'm certainly not from the brains inside. Your fucking back of your neck should be airy and fucking stress-free. Holding up a walnut. A fucking hollow coconut with a fucking walnut hanging in there.
What are you going to do?
I knew you were going to say what.
Where was this? Was this on video or released anywhere?
Yeah, this is actually, it was actually big in fucking, I think, Taiwan or some shit.
No, it wasn't.
Really?
Yeah, they redid the cover and made it. It was supposed to be one
better
of those. What'd you say?
Better actors.
I wish they did.
As far as you can see, are these rock formations growing hundreds of feet right up out of the ground. We're all made of this red sandstone, so at night when the sun starts to set, it's like the whole valley's on fire, Allison.
What emotion you put into that.
Exactly. Oh, like
fucking watered down pony boy.
Fire, what you like.
Oh, Jesus.
If you're looking for God, that's where you find him.
If it's so amazing, why'd you come back? I mean, it can be so depressing around here, don't you think? Same old places, same old faces. Dylan, it doesn't matter.
That's
I'm just glad you're here.
That's it.
Allison! I need you in here!
We'll go to the,
I better go.
Hey, Allison. I miss you.
All right, Bobby.
We like to do time machine bits on this show.
Yeah?
If you had the chance to go in a time machine and talk to this Bob Kelly, what would you do to him?
I would say,
try emoting a little when you act.
I would try.
I've heard fucking blimpy subs ordered with more fucking passion and range. Fucking asshole.
At least I don't just make faces of the emotion. Angry. Oh.
Sad. Oh.
You might want to try
happy.
It.
If you're looking for God, here's where you find him. Really? State your floor. We have bras on floor 3 and bathing suits on the 4th floor. And when you're looking for God, here's where you go. There's sandstone, Alice. There sure is sandstone. You know what, Alice? I missed you, Alice. One level. That's all I do. I'm the same guy at all moments, Alice.
There's actually one with some emotion in it where I tell her I love her.
Oh yeah.
Is it nausea from the audience?
Hey, is it true that hunger strike is being played in the background of that scene?
I don't know.
Someone is suggesting that hunger strike is playing in the background of that scene.
Be
I love you, Alice. I missed you. You'd never know it to talk to me. You'd have to read it in the script to know I missed you.
Yeah, that wasn't...